Crawl space encapsulation or insulation? That is the question. What is it? What is the difference between the two? Why does it matter? Well, let me break it down for you, Brainiac style. So the difference between crawlspace insulation and encapsulation, let's talk about crawlspace encapsulation first. Essentially, crawlspace encapsulation is done to help with any kind of moisture issues or water issues that you have in your crawlspace. When they add crawlspace encapsulation, essentially they're putting down a liner. What I like to think of is kind of like a pool liner. So what that does is that's going to help with any of those moisture issues or leaks that you have coming in from your foundation. So the benefits of crawlspace encapsulation are, it's going to prevent any kind of like mold growth from the moisture. It's also going to improve your indoor air quality because, like I said, it's preventing mold growth. The encapsulation is also going to stop any kind of structural damage that you may have due to these water leaks, like damage to your foundation or even your home structure. So to clarify, encapsulation is necessary if you have any kind of standing water and water leaks. Now, a lot of times when people do encapsulation, they also incorporate a dehumidifier to help with any kind of residual humidity that may come up. Now let's talk about crawl space insulation. Are you dealing with cold floors, frozen pipes, things like that? That is probably air moving up through your crawl space, so you'll want to insulate it. Crawl space insulation, essentially, we'll use spray foam for an example because it is a good product to use in this area, and I'm about to tell you why. Insulating the crawl space, what you want to do is you want to block air movement from coming up through the floors and through the rim joist of your home. A product like spray foam is going to create an air barrier that's going to keep that air from getting up into your living space. So the benefits of adding a material like spray foam insulation to your crawl space is it's going to stop those cold floors and uncomfortable rooms. It's also going to help prevent your pipes from freezing. Another great thing about foam insulation is that if you have any kind of moisture issues in the crawl space, it's not going to retain any of that moisture, which can lead to structural damage. Because it doesn't absorb moisture, that means it's not going to contribute to any kind of mold or mildew growth. And finally, another added benefit is if your home's more comfortable because you're not dealing with cold floors, that can actually help reduce your energy bills. So I explained the difference between encapsulation and insulation, but there is a note that I do want to make here. Encapsulation and a vapor barrier are not the same thing. A vapor barrier is going to prevent any kind of moisture from coming up from the ground into the crawl space. Now, this is only a small part of actual encapsulation. Now, encapsulation, that really seals everything. So if you have moisture from the ground coming up, or if you actually have foundation leaks and standing water, that is specifically what encapsulation is made to do, is seal those things out. Encapsulation and insulation, do you need both? Heck yeah, you do. Encapsulation will handle all of your moisture issues, whereas insulation is going to handle your energy efficiency and comfort issues. Insulation is made to block the air, which is making your home uncomfortable. And encapsulation is meant to block the moisture and water, which could cause damage to your home. So if you have both, then you have a perfectly healthy crawl space. Now, if you want to learn more about building science, home insulation, and everything awesome that foam insulation can do, check out the Learning Center on our website. There you're going to find tons of articles, videos, and resources to answer all of your questions. I'm your building science brainiac, reminding you to bring a little science to every project.